Shalom Talmidim and welcome to Rega Be'ivrit. This Torah portion this week, Parashat Ki Tseh, gives us an amazing and wonderful Hebrew lesson that found in verse 15. It is says there in 31, Exodus 31, 15, Sheshet Yamim, 6 days, Ya'aseh Melacha. Now the question is, what is melacha? Your Bible will translate it as the word work, but the word work in Hebrew is the word avodah. What is the difference between melacha and avodah? Melacha comes from the Hebrew word melech, the kingdom. 6 days a person is to build the kingdom of God, but on the 7th day is to rest. Now here's the problem. What is melacha? The scripture is not telling us nowhere what is melacha, but there is a prohibition of doing melacha. And then in verse 15 it says, Sheshet yamim yaseh melacha, u'beyom ha'shvi'i shabbat shabbaton. And in verse 16 he said, whoever does melacha on the Shabbat will be dying, will die. Which proved to us that there is such thing as an oral Torah. How do we know that there is such a thing towards an oral Torah? Otherwise the Torah is ambiguous. Melacha, nobody knows what is a melacha is, which we can assume that it's been transferred to us by Moses down to the people verbally. And then in verse 16 is a verse we sing every Shabbat. Veshamru b'nei Yisrael et ha-Shabbat lasot et ha-Shabbat ledorotam berit olam. I want you to notice something about the verse. Each verb have 3 root letters. Alchu, dibru, shamru, shamar. When you see a vav in the end of the verb, like shamru, achlu, dibru, it means that it's a corporate commandment. It's a commandment given to all of Israel. Therefore, if one is not part of a fellowship, is not part of a community, he does not even keep a Shabbat. Do you understand this? This is very important. And here it does not say to keep the Shabbat. It is say shamru, which comes from the word shamar, like shomer Israel. Hine lo yanum velo ishan, shomer Israel. Ushamru b'nei Israel, mean that Israel commanded to guard the Shabbat. And how did they guard the Shabbat? By not doing melacha. I would like to challenge you, this Shabbat is not just to keep the Shabbat, but to guard the Shabbat. Ask yourself the question, do you guard the Shabbat? What does it mean to guard the Shabbat? That is the word shamar, shamru. And what does it mean to us to guard the Shabbat together as a community? I hope you enjoyed this lesson in Rega Be'ivrit. God bless you, little.